Do you have any clue what happened to him? How his story ended?
With Angelus. But first of all, thank you all very much for coming, firstly, and then thank you for staying as well. Angelus, ultimately, he was freed by his family. They got the alimony payment together and pieced it all together, and they were able to get him released. But as Julie said, right at the end, she was going to do another, serve him, as they say, with another alimony payment. But she did, from it, which was also a back payment that had not been paid. And then he went on the run yet again to a neighboring province, and this time many, many, many miles away, and stayed there for a number of months. And then, and you can maybe tell the village that out of sight, out of mind. You know, mm-hmm. if it's not right there, then it kind of goes under the radar, slows down, and then he ultimately returned. And then after that, he began a new family with a new one.
So, and he never arrived in Australia, apparently?
No, he didn't. He killed to this place, as you saw, and he actually had boarded a plane. He was actually meant to go to court and to see a judge about this mm-hmm. case, Geronimo. And it was a situation where he said to the judge that he was going to be there, and then he left and went to Bornu, which is the capital of Papua New Guinea, expecting that he was going to be able to get on a plane and go to Australia. But then the Surfing Association, who was organizing the trip, couldn't be a part of that. Mm-hmm. And this is a story that was told to me by Andy. I met them in Australia, of course, and I heard this story. So Angelus was this close. So,
And we decided for Ezekiel to go because he was actually eliminated by Mr. Graham.
Right, yeah. They call it a brownie point system, but they want the best competitor at the same time as they want someone